guys, Steph here, and welcome to a brand new video. In this episode, we're going to take a look at a statement that a lot of people have talked about, at least in the past couple of months, and that's going to be about Bowser's Fury, the side mode that came along with the newest release of 3D World that came out in the Wii U first and recently came on Switch way back in February. The thing is that a lot of people were stating that Bowser's Fury was going to become the future of 3D Mario games, and I wanted to jump in into the opinions, but I couldn't bring myself to do it because it didn't make any sense. A lot of people were saying a bunch of stuff. I just finished the game. Like, at the time that I did my video of 3D World, I had already beaten Bowser's Fury, and a lot of people were saying a bunch of stuff, saying that it was fantastic, that it was the new best thing, like every single Mario game from this moment onward was going to be like Bowser's Fury. So I sat around with my Switch, played the mode one more time, wanted to see what else the game had to offer. I wanted to see why people were saying this, and if it was true, the fact that it was going to become the future of 3D Mario games. And the answer is that I don't think it's going to be the future. Nintendo always tries to do something newer, but I think their approach of the basis of 3D Mario games is going to change. Let me explain. Super Mario 64 added something that was fantastic. The fact that you would go to different levels and each level would have different missions. These missions would do a lot of different stuff, but the unanimous opinion that a lot of people disliked was the fact that you would be kicked out of a stage every single time. You get a star, you get kicked out. And that's something that has been continuously rewritten itself every single time that they release a mainline 3D Mario game, with the exception of 3D World, because as I said in my video about 3D World, is essentially structurized like a 2D Mario game. The reason why you were kicked out of every single level after you get a star is because every stage is not built for every mission. For example, the most basic one. Go to Bob on Battlefield. In the first star, in the first episode, you would fight King Bobomb atop of the mountain. But in the second mission, King Bobomb is missing and you have Koopa the Quick that is going to race you. But Koopa the Quick is not present in any other episode. What this means is that it allows the player to experience the same level doing different things every single time. And this is something that has been continuously endured the test of time with Sunshine, Galaxy and Galaxy 2, with the exception of Odyssey. Now, Super Mario Odyssey is like a really special case because it's a really good game, it's actually fantastic, it has the best movement and everything that we've ever seen in a Mario game, and there's no kicking you out of the stage after you get a Power Moon. Why is that? Because you have a full interactive world that has little updates to get different stars. And overall, this was actually good because a lot of people loved the freedom that Odyssey gave you, but to me at least, it hampered something that was fantastic, the satisfaction of getting a hard Power Moon, because it was flooded by lesser difficult Power Moons, some that were laying around in the overworld, others that were underground, and others given to you by minigames that, let's just face it, weren't necessarily good. I've said all of this about these Mario games, and where does it get us when it comes to Bowser's Fury? Well, Bowser's Fury did both. Did what Odyssey did really well of having stages that would update themselves a little bit every time you get a Power Moon, and at the same time, it will not boot you out of the stage, but you still had memorable catch shines that made sense when you grabbed them. Bowser's Fury does everything that these games try to accomplish in their own way, mesh them together, and makes it fantastic. A fully explorable world? Check. Levels that made sense? Check. Not kicking you out of the level? Check. Memorable catch shines? Check. All encompassed together with a really good boss fight, really good fights, and overall a really good narrative. It's super simple, it's a 5-hour experience, and it feels like a tech demo of what's coming next in the Mario games. It's fantastic, it works really good, and it's really fun. The access to power-ups on the slider anytime you want it, the help of Bowser Jr., the environment, everything that was encompassed with it was done in a really good way that not every single Mario game has been able to replicate. Now, Bowser's Fury, I don't feel like it's going to be the BioBeal next format that every single Mario game is going to follow in the future, because Nintendo has never done that. They follow specific patterns, but everything else gets always mixed and changed. You don't have the same structure from Sunshine into Galaxy, or into Galaxy to Galaxy 2, even though it's a sequel. What we're saying is that there's a bunch of stuff going for them, and I think Bowser's Fury was actually a step into the right direction. If you're a fan of Nintendo that really like Mario games but would love not to be kicked out of a level every single time, this is definitely the game for you. If you felt that there was underwhelming, that at the lighter half of Mario Odyssey the moons lost its purpose, well, you're going to have a really good time with Bowser's Fury 2. It's a really good thing, and the best thing about it is that it comes bundled right in with a really good game that is 3D World. So, to conclude all this gibberish of this video, do I think Bowser's Fury is going to be the definition or what's going to be of 3D Mario games in the future? And my answer is probably. Like, it can be part of the future, but the next Mario game is not going to be solely structured as Bowser's Fury. That's what I'm trying to say. But that's just one mind's opinion. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I will see you guys pretty soon with another video that I hope is going to be to your liking. See you guys then.